Hello everyone, welcome to the very first episode of Cockpit, Mothership's new news roundup talk show, where we talk cop, sometimes sing song, and if it's a slow news week, we play mahjong. My name is Josiah Ng, and the only reason why I'm the one hosting this new talk show on Mothership is because we got no budget to hire Xia Xue. My bosses told me that there were only two criteria they needed in a host for Mothership's own talk show. Number one, someone that's cheap, or in my case, free. Number two, someone who won't joke about bald women. I hope to unpack and round up recent news, and if you enjoy yourself, feel free to share, like, comment, give emoji, you know, all these are all free, okay? I mean, if you don't, it's fine as well. We will find comfort in our fake live audience. Yeah. You hear the laughter and the clapping, yeah. All that is added in post-production, because again, no budget yet, unless there are some sponsors who would like to sponsor this show. Yeah, you can email us. First up, guys, Singapore has eased up its COVID-19 measures from the 29th of March 2022. Speaking of easing up, Minister of Health in Singapore, Ong Ye Kung, is now on TikTok and recently posted his very first video, and that's not the most surprising thing. What's surprising, for me at least, is that within just 24 hours, he's gotten almost 800,000 views, and no, he wasn't dancing like a Xiao Mei Mei.
Hi guys, this is Ong Ye Kung, Minister for Health, Singapore. I just started a TikTok account. Today is my first video. Today is also the first day Singapore is easing all our safe management measures. So I'm in my office, got my mask on, and I'm going to the market. See you in a while.
Finally, I get to see the faces of my staff. I'm not going into Yong Tau Fu market, it's enclosed, there are more population, not as good compared to out here, so good to wear a mask.
800,000 views, guys, within 24 hours. I mean, which proves SMMs can fight XMMs. On the 24th of March 2022, when PM announced the easing of COVID-19 measures in the AM.
Fourth, wearing masks outdoors will now be optional.
So now let me recap some of these measures which took effect on the 29th of March 2022, and I believe some of my colleagues will be placing links to articles about these measures in the comment section. Group sizes will be doubled from 5 to 10 people. Now remember how, like, you know, we had to choose which of our 5 friends we wanted to hang out with because we could only dine in with 5 people, right? And we could only have 5 friends in our homes. Now, no need, okay? Up to 10 visitors can visit your house and you can dine in at restaurants and coffee shops in groups of 10 if you're vaccinated. So if up till now, no one jio you and ask you out to eat with them, I'm sorry, I mean, you probably have no friends, yeah. And by that, actually, I mean I think I have no friends, yeah. This whole live stream is around about attempt to gain my friends' attention, I think. Yeah, I don't know why, but since I joined Mothership, no one jio me. The second measure, the wearing of masks outdoors will be optional, but you still must wear masks indoors. This has to be one of the most exciting news because for close to 2 years, we've all had to stay safe with our mask on. In fact, we went down on the streets on the 29th of March itself when the COVID-19 easing measures took effect to hear what you think and whether you would still wear a mask.
Hello everybody, I'm Angela from Mothership, and today we are outside Marina Bay Sands because it's the first day where we are allowed to go maskless outdoors since April 2020. So it's been 2 years. So what's going to happen now is we are going to walk towards this outdoor route, towards Raffles Place. So we'll be able to see the situation, like how many people actually go maskless outdoors and like how many people still are keeping their mask on. So I see that you are still, you still have your mask on. Yeah, so.
Is there a reason why? I think it's a new normal, right? I didn't even think twice when I stepped out of the office that, oh, okay, I can remove it now. It's like become part of my face now that I don't feel like, unless I step into my house.
Other people are not worrying. I think I should protect myself at least.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Do you think it's same?
Yeah.
Oh, okay, so under what circumstances will you remove your mask?
When we're eating.
Oh, yeah. Only, so like the usual lah.
Yes, yeah. Yes, okay, right.
For you as well.
Yeah. Mm.
Oh, okay, interesting. Thank you so much.
Okay.
Hi, I'm here at Clark Quay on the first night that alcohol restrictions are lifted, so we're just going to ask people how they feel.
Freedom! We can feel the freedom!
This is the moment we have been waiting for. It's time to come out and party. We need it. You know it.
Okay, finally, I don't have to put this on, which is this mask. I don't have to put this on. I just put it on the floor and I just step it. Okay? And yes, I feel so good without a mask right now. Okay, but unfortunately, I need to go when I go inside the club. I need to put on a mask. But when you drink, you don't have to put on a mask.
It's good, you know. This is the latest I've been out in like a year.
How does it feel like to finally drink and then not get chased away at
10:30? Oh, trust and believe. We as drag queens in Singapore, we need this.
You want to find out more? Head to our Facebook page to see Angela in her cow shirt. Hear people call be kabu. The third measure is that the capacity limit for larger events in settings of more than 1,000 people will be increased to 75%. Great, great news for those in the MICE industry. And all the mega churches say, amen. Number four, up to 75% of employees who can work from home will be able to return to workplace. Okay, next. And of course, sale and consumption of alcohol in F&B outlets will be allowed after 10:30 p.m. Now, I know when I mention things like this, the first thing you buggers will be asking is, hey, how? Nightlife how? Siam tiu how? Huh? Karaoke how? Clubbing how? Oh my God, I got existential crisis. Sorry, this is not Kong Tao Help Desk. This is Mothership, okay? Mothership, yeah? So, co-chair of the Multi-Ministry Task Force, Minister Lawrence Wong, has mentioned that relevant government agencies are still looking into the resumption of activities in nightlife. So, akan datang, let's wait and see, yeah? In the meantime, please guys, touch wood. Let's hope the situation truly gets better. And you guys keep your morning wood in your pants. Touch your own wood if you must, I guess. We really need to get out of the woods. So which of these measures are you most excited about and why? Comment in the thread below. Next up, Swatch and Omega teamed up recently and they released a new series of their watches, the Bio-Ceramic Moon Swatch, and many in Singapore queued up for hours for it.
No, from 4 a.m. together, then you cut us out like that, and then shot at us. We cooperate with the bloody brand manager. He asked us to move back, we move back, that's why we are behind, and then he cut us behind. Then you're doing what? Na chang sao, huh?
As you can see, the situation very quickly went from Omega to oh my god. Now, like some of you, I shook my head as if I was a saint, right, who never queued up in his entire life. And I thought it was a Singaporean thing, but you know, like ever since the Hello Kitty McDonald's soft toy craze, Singaporeans have been known to queue for everything, you know, like it is our national pastime. But then I realized that this moon swatch queue is not a Singapore thing. You know, some regions had buyers run, like literally they ran in a horde to get their hands on a watch. So get this, it's not even limited edition. So how to make sense of this? Now, first of all, from what we've read and researched, the Omega is touted as the moon watch, and in fact has a moon watch line which goes for thousands of dollars. The Omega was one of the first wristwatches that was reportedly worn on the moon. I mean, if a watch can survive space and land on the moon, I mean, it does speak of its quality, right? So my sensing is that Swatch collaborating with Omega and then naming it, Moon Swatch, it's sure gonna turn heads, right? I mean, plus with a price tag of $300-ish, like what? You know, it's a steal. And in Singapore, the only way you can steal legally is with deals like this. And I mean, of course, people are gonna try and get their hands on it, right? So in this case, it's not limited edition. In fact, it's no limits edition, which in my opinion is as attractive in a marketing sense. Why? Because I used to be limited in my ability to get a branded watch, but now I have no limits. But to many, and I've been told this before, by the way, I mean, a watch tells you what kind of person you are. So one day, reminds me of a story. One day, I was wearing my Casio BMT watch. I went for a business meeting. And after I introduced myself, the first thing the other party told me was, "Hey man, a person's watch tells me what kind of man you are. So, the watch you're wearing, are you cheap? Or what? You sign on regular, is it?" I was stunned, of course, right? And after giggling nervously, I looked at him and then I looked at my watch. You know, it wasn't a moon watch, right? It was a down-to-earth watch. And all I could say at that time was, I don't need my watch to tell people what kind of man I am. I just need my watch to tell the time. I didn't get the business, of course, and now I'm working for Mothership. The moon swatch incident, as I would call it, is actually a statement about value, in my opinion. People give value to different things based on how they feel about it. It's quite subjective. And to me, you know, instead of laughing at why people are queuing up for a watch, maybe I should ask myself, what am I doing to create value for others? Let us know what you think in the comments. The last news roundup for this episode, I wanted it to be about how we were all rushing to Changi to catch the bioluminescent. Say that 10 times quickly. Bioluminescent water last weekend. You know, like you slap the water, then got the blue glow. But since last Monday, the trending thing is Will Smith's slap. Slap as in, he slapped Chris Rock, the face kinda blue and black. Not the bioluminescent kind, but arguably still blue and black. Unless you've been living under a rock, the Chris Rock, you would know that in the Academy Awards in Hollywood, what happened was that I guess you could say that the joke was too slapstick for Will, and Chris Rock's punchline was very punchable. Now, when I saw the footage, a few questions came to mind. Did Will Smith overreact? I mean, he was, after all, standing up for his wife. Did Chris Rock cross the line? I mean, isn't he just trying to be a comedian and make everyone laugh? Now, here's what I think. Hair, I think, is intrinsically linked to one's identity. It's why bad hair day is such a thing. For people with alopecia, which was what Jada had, an autoimmune disorder, I can imagine it all adds up on top of having a disease. So I figure that a joke like this actually cuts deep into issues about identity, which leads to wealth, which leads to probably why Will Smith decided to do what he did. But of course, I think we can all agree that violence is never right, and I'm not condoning or justifying what Will Smith did. In fact, you know, he shouldn't have smacked Chris Rock. But on the other hand, one should never joke about another person's plight and sickness. Which got me thinking about the role of comedy, actually. In fact, I want to quote Terry Pratchett, an author, who said that satire is meant to ridicule power. If you're laughing at people who are hurting, it's not satire, it's bullying. But the other question is this: will this be the death of comedy? Will everyone get too sensitive about humour, and, you know, with cancel culture looming, in fact, does this mean that Singaporean comedians, you know, people like Kumar, Shah Rukh Khanna, Rishi Budrani, the Dim Sum Dollies, Fakafas, Sam C, Hirzi Zulkifli, Mr. Brown, Mr. Miyagi, Judy Tan, Siti Khalijah, Gurmit Singh, Annette Lee, you know, all these funny Singaporeans who've made my day better, will they suddenly be so careful that we can't laugh at ourselves anymore? Now, I have a kid. He's about 5 years old. In fact, I tell him almost every other week, you know, that he should make someone laugh. One day he came back, his face was defeated, and he told me, "Papa, teacher made me stand, and I cannot play toys because my friend was angry." I probed a little deeper, and he said that he was trying to play a prank on this friend just to make everyone laugh. But as a result, it caused this friend to hurt. Well, of course, I hugged him, and I personally learned that day that if one person cries while the rest of the room was laughing, it wasn't a good joke at all. Comedy is supposed to heal. laughter is the best medicine. In fact, scientifically, I mean, when we laugh, endorphins are released. Endorphins, like, you know, your body, I mean, they're like your body's natural painkillers, right? Laughter makes you feel less alone. It's a signal that, you know, you can get through your own pain. It's a catharsis. So if you want comedy to live, I think comedians all around the world need to make sure that their comedy continues to give life. And I mean, think about it. That's what comedy is. It gives life. And the last question I have is this. Since we like to copy Hollywood so much, will there be a slapping incident at this year's Star Awards? Before we come to the end of the first episode, I would be remiss if I didn't mention our upcoming Mothership YouTube original series, I Am.
Hello, my name is Adeline and I'm living with alopecia totalis. In general, what alopecia is, right, is actually a fancy term for hair loss. It's up to your immune system, I guess, because autoimmune, right, it means that your body is attacking itself. I tend to lose the hair that's on my face and my scalp. So at times, I will lose my eyebrow, my eyelashes. Sometimes I'll lose it in patches. Like I have a cool eyebrow slit like that. Or sometimes it's like, wow, completely the entire eyebrow gone.
I Am is a series where we feature extraordinary individuals who did not allow their circumstances to define who they are. And in light of the recent happenings, we thought it would be good to publish this episode about Adeline and how she's living with alopecia and living bravely. So subscribe to Mothership's YouTube channel and catch the series. More episodes will be uploaded very, very soon. Thank you so much for tuning in, guys. We've got no budget for a live audience, so the applause you hear right now, it's added in post-production. Till next time, remember, in Denzel Washington's words, in your highest moments, be careful. That's when the devil comes for you. Have a great one, guys. Goodbye.
Thanks for watching this video. If you'd like to see more, don't forget to click on the subscribe button and the notification bell.